And welcome back. The American Heart Association reports every 37 seconds that someone will die from heart-related disease, and it can happen to anyone at any age.
Yeah, new this morning, Aaron Fields talked to a local man wanting to shed light on getting checked out, no matter how healthy a person may think they are. Good morning, Aaron.
Good morning, Josh and Alicia. So y'all have heard of Mike Seminary, haven't you?
Yes.
He's the former Bismarck mayor, and he's also probably one of the most dedicated runners I've met in my life.
Right, right.
But Seminary has made running an everyday priority since 1975. However, he recently had to undergo an angioplasty surgery and wants to stress the importance of getting checked out no matter how much exercise you do.
No, I don't like taking days off. If it's that cold, I'll go to the Y and do the loops.
65-year-old Mike Seminary tells me he runs 5 miles every single morning. His general rules of thumb are if it's negative 25 degrees or the wind chill is negative 40 degrees or below, he won't go out. Other than that, everything else is free game for him.
Because of either an injury or a real significant illness, which is just rare, I'm aware of one time in all the years that I've been running that I missed 4 consecutive days, and that was really hard on me.
Seminary also keeps a very healthy diet. However, about 5 years ago, he was told he had high cholesterol. Then last November, he was told the same thing again and was told to get a calcium test done, which he admits he forgot to do until one day he was in for an oil change.
The guy was giving me a ride to the office here, younger than me, and he was talking about he had just had a calcium score test. And the day they had his test, they scheduled an emergency bypass surgery for him. So I called the doctor. I said, we probably should get that taken care of.
And good thing he did call, because after having his own calcium test done, they told him his calcium levels were at 1,400, and the average person usually scores anywhere from 3 to 500. They then performed an angioplasty surgery and had 2 stents put in.
This calcium score test, it isn't something that's going to be this great revelation for everyone, right? But it cost me $25, and it took about 5 minutes. And it might have saved my life.
He says the surgery was quick and he is back to normal. He's only had to modify his diet a little and pays more attention to food labels. And for running, he says nothing will keep him from that.
I haven't missed a beat. The day of my stress test I ran, the day of my procedure I ran, the day I was released I ran.
And Seminary says although he is healthy, he did have risk factors, including a family history of high cholesterol and heart attacks. But I was going to go meet him out this morning and do a live shot with him, but because of the coronavirus the photog has
a lot of other factors to consider there. How dedicated.
Yeah, my rule of thumb, though, it has to be 50 or above 50 for me to go outside and run. Yeah.
Yeah, but he runs, and I'm sure he warms up pretty quickly, a matter of getting out there.
When I used to live here the first time in Bismarck, I would go out running and see him, and he's always at a real fast clip, and it's just what an incredible guy. And then also, running on the day of his surgery.
Right.
Wow.
So important message to run, eat health, or to exercise.
Yeah. And get those calcium score tests.
Focus on your genetics.
That's right. That's right, for sure. All right, thanks for sharing that story there, Aaron.